Okay girls, in the last PPT we have discussed about distance vector routing and link state routing algorithm. So this is one of the topic that is remained in the first unit, that is TCP/IP protocol. So one question, that is OSI layers, 7 layers, and another question, in some cases they will ask this question also, that is TCP/IP protocol. What is this TCP/IP protocol? TCP stands for Transmission Control Protocol, IP stands for Internet Protocol. So these are the two protocols used in the internet. So all these protocols will exist in these 5 layers, that is physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer. So TCP/IP is a hierarchical protocol made of interactive modules, each of which provides specific functionality, but they are not necessarily independent. Okay, so all these protocols will be placed in the hierarchical model, so that some of the layers can use the different types of protocols. The term hierarchical specifies that each upper layer protocol is supported by one or more layer protocols. So whatever the lower layer protocols are there, those are used or supported by the upper layer protocol. That's why they are saying it as a hierarchical. See here, this is our TCP/IP protocol. So we have physical layer, next we have data link layer, we have network layer, we have transport layer, and last three are combined: session, presentation, application layer. So in the network layer we have the protocols like ICMP, IGMP, IP, ARP and RARP. In transport layer we have two protocols, TCP and UDP. Application, presentation, session layers consist of SMTP, FTP, Telnet, DNS, SNMP, NFS, RPC and TFTP protocols. So all these layers will use these types of protocols for their usage, for their functionality. The network layer will do one type of work, transport layer will do one type of work, application, presentation, session layer will do another type of work. So when they are doing their own work, they will use these protocols to complete the work. So first we'll discuss about SMT protocol. We'll start from the top. So in the application, presentation, session layers, the first layer is the protocol is SMTP. What is SMTP? SMTP stands for Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. It was designed in the year 1982. The name itself says that it is a simple mail transfer protocol. It is updated in the year 2008. It is an application, it belongs to an application layer protocols. SMTP's duties are end-to-end method, it use and store and forward method. So the name itself says that it is a simple mail transfer protocol. So it is going to transfer our mails from sender to the receiver side. So what are the functionalities? It is going to send end-to-end, so peer-to-peer protocol. So one client, one server will be there. So it is going to select the packet from the sender and it's going to receive to the receiver side. So store and forward method. So where we have discussed in a message switching protocol, we have heard the word store and forward, means all the packets once getting from the sender, it's going to store in a buffer. After finishing all the packets, then it is going to forward. When the link is free, it is going to forward the packets to the destination. That is simple mail transfer protocol. Next is FTP. It is a standard network protocol. It is used to transfer the computer files between the client and server on computer network. So FTP stands for file transfer protocol. So it is going to transfer all the files from the sender to the receiver side. So it is built on client-server model architecture. It is using a separate control. So FTP's file transfer protocol is going to transfer all the files from sender to the receiver side. Next protocol is Telnet protocol. So Telnet means it is stands for telecommunication network. So Telnet is a program which allows users on one system to log on to remote system. So one system is in one area and another system is in remote areas. So if you want to log on to these two systems, we'll use a program called Telnet program. It is used in the application protocol on the internet network, or we can use in the local area network. And it uses a concept called virtual terminal connection. So VT, virtual terminal, it is nothing but if you want to transfer the data from local to the remote areas, we need a virtual terminal software. So that is nothing but telnet program. Next is DNS. DNS stands for domain name system. DNS translate domain names to the IP addresses. In a distributed database, we have some hierarchy of name of servers. So in this TCP/IP protocol is used in different platforms. So DNS, in simple words, we can say that DNS is like a phone book on internet. So which consists of all the phone addresses, okay, IP addresses. Next, SNMP is nothing but simple network management protocol. Is an internet standard protocol. It is going to collect and organize all information. The simple network management is going to manage all the networking system in the sender and receiver side. So it is used in the application layer protocol. Next is NFS, NFC, nothing but near field communication protocol. It is a set of communicating protocol for communication between two electronic devices over a distance of 4 centimeters, the short range wireless connectivity. So if client, if sender and the receiver have a shortest distance, like 4 centimeters only, so we use this near field communication protocol to exchange information between sender and the receiver. So it is a simple one. RPC is nothing but remote procedure call. It is a protocol that one program can use to request a service from program located on their computer without having to understand the network details. It is nothing but a procedure call. We can also sometimes call it as a function call or subroutine call. Remote procedure means if our receiver has is placed in the remote areas, we are going to request a service. Means whether the link is free or whether the receiver is free or not, depending on that one, we are going to exchange the information. Next is TFTP, Tribal File Transfer Protocol, which is allowed. This allows that client to get a file or put a file on the remote host. It's a simple file transfer protocol. So TFTP uses FTP to transport our data from sender to the receiver side. It's a tribal file transfer protocol. So if you want to send a data to the remote areas, we'll go for TFTP. So TCP transmission control protocol, which is going to exchange the messages between the network. So UDP is a user datagram protocol used to send the messages called datagrams. So we and it is the best service made for the communication, TCP or UDP. Next is ICMP, Internet Control Message Protocol. It is used in the internet working devices, including like routers, to send error messages. It is used for reporting errors. So it is a main protocol. If any error occurs in the transmission, it's going to give a error message to the client or sender or receiver. So error has occurred. So IGMP is the Internet Group Management Protocol. It is used by the host adjacent routers to establish a multicast grouping membership. So if we have the number of internet members, so that we can establish a multicast grouping membership using this IGMP protocol. So ARP is nothing but Address Resolution Protocol, used by the client computers to request its IPE address from computer network. Is used for discovering the link layer address such as MAC address. So Address Resolution Protocol will have the MAC address in the internet. So it is going to discover the address such as MAC address using this ARP. RARP is the Reverse Address Resolution Protocol, used by the client computer to request its IP address from the computer network. So RARP is reverse. It is going to ask the sender what is the address of the IP address of that system. So IP is an internet protocol by which data is sent from one computer to another computer on the internet. So generally we listen these words, these protocol, that is IP internet protocol. So if we have this protocol, we can send information from one computer to another computer. Each computer on internet has one IP address that uniquely identifies all the computers on the network. So these are the all the protocols. You have to draw this one, and you have to write at least two sentences about this, all these protocols: TCP, Telnet, IGMP, IRP, IP. Okay, so this question may occur in the first unit. Okay, so thank you, guys.